くでも一人じゃないさ生まれてきたことに必ず意味がある優しさに満ち溢れてる青い星にありがとう You can smile again
And so, in the past I made several websites and everything had the same fate. They painfully died with an agonizing fatality. And that was destined to happen since day one, because I was always making the same mistake. I was hosting on dedicated servers, and let's face it, nobody wants to maintain a server. I could use cloud solutions, but the cost is beyond any imagination, plus paying for a lifetime doesn't sound like a great idea. So it is time to make things properly, and create a site that we won't pay for, we won't need to maintain, and most importantly, it will never go down. Obviously I'm talking about hosting on GitHub, but perhaps not so obviously, we can host lots more than static pages. Although that's out of this video scope. So anyway, last day I opened this repository on GitHub, and then I created a custom domain name. And most specifically the babywogue.world. So if I type it on Omnibox, I can see my GitHub pages. Basically I'm opening this page to make some Linux guides, and one I want to make crazy a lot, is how we can compose and distribute custom silver blue images. But most importantly, I'm opening it to start writing some lore for the babywogue YouTube, because I'm planning to make it more like filmography. And also to share all the materials, code and models. Or maybe I'll get super lazy and I won't do anything. Anywho, it is time for the actual video, and don't watch this like a guide, but as a motivation to create your own site. It is super easy and super cheap, you only need to pay for the domain name. Okay, so let's start, and the first thing we need to do is to create a new repository. And I will call it BW World, for babywogue.world. Next we have two options, public and private. If we make it private, we won't be able to publish our page, unless we get a GitHub commercial plan. So if we want to have sensitive data on our page, like keys for connecting to cloud services, we should also buy a GitHub plan. But for now we'll just go with public. And create repository. Next step is to create our first HTML file. And again we have two options. The first is to create a file on the root of the repository. For example index.md. Or, to have a more clear structure we can create our files inside some directory, for example Gatsby and index.md. The problem is that GitHub won't accept Gatsby name, and I'm not quite sure if we can use custom folder names for GitHub pages. But one name that certainly works is the docs. So docs and index.md. And just type something like hello babywogue world. And by the way that's the official babywogue shortcode, small b and capital W. And commit the changes. Okay. The next scene according to this movie script, is to go to repository settings. And scroll all the way down to the GitHub pages section. Here we'll select the main branch of our repository, and next we will select the docs folder, unless if we have created the file on root directory. And save. At this point, we can already see our page in the default GitHub URL. And the reason I'm opening in incognito mode, is for escaping the cache issues. Anyway, so that's our home page. But closing this, and let's finally create a custom domain name. So we again scroll down, with this perfectly smoothly Chrome scrolling in Linux. And on custom domain, I will add the bw.world. And save. Something that troubled me like a lot, actually I spent like 2 hours, was the force HTTPS option. It says it is unavailable because the domain is not properly configured. The problem was that even after we get everything perfectly correct, we might still get this error. And the solution is that it needs time to propagate. In my case took more than 2 to 3 hours, and in fact I saw it working when I woke up. One last thing to mention before we set up the name on our domain provider. It said after we set up a custom name on GitHub settings, GitHub auto-committed a CNAME file. Basically we can remove this, push it again, or edit it, without getting into settings every time. Just saying because it is faster. Next I'm going to use GoDaddy to set up the DNS names, and that's not a GoDaddy advertisement, but more like a Google blaming. You see, I bought the .world domain for $2 in GoDaddy, but Google asks for $40, and not to mention they don't even sell in Greece. But then again they have YouTube, so they're forgiven. So, now we are on GoDaddy console, and you only need to do three things. First you need to add these four alpha records. You could copy the IP addresses from here, but always read the official documentation. Also, GoDaddy by default creates a parked alpha record, so you need to delete that. Next, for HTTPS to work, you need a CAA record. Without explaining the properties, you need to set 0 on flags, issue on tag, and let's encrypt.org on value. And after that, give it a few hours and go back to GitHub settings and enable the HTTPS. And obviously the most critical record is to set a CNAME. For host you will set your domain name, and you want this to point to your GitHub username, plus github.io. Notice you shouldn't add the full repository name, like /babywogue etc. And that was pretty much everything. All you need now is to wait a bit for the changes to take effect. Oh, and just because that's a Linux video, you can also open a terminal and dig it. One thing I didn't really care to mention, is on GitHub pages you can get Jekyll engine integration. But if that's your first web page ever, I would strongly suggest to use Gatsby for publishing your site.
やり続けることに必ず意味がある You just try